There have been a lot of sneakers that have come out through the years that were so hyped, but when I finally got them in hand and put them on my feet, I was so disappointed. And one of those sneakers were the Adidas 4D. It was so hyped because they 4D printed the midsole. There was so much promise about it being customized so that it would deliver the best kind of cushioning and support for your feet. Or that it was such a technological advancement and marvel that it would be the next phase for sneakers. However, after putting it on, it was just a hard shoe. And there were issues with potentially cleaning it because of how open and how weird the midsole looked like. Now, in the last few months, I reviewed a couple of Adidas 4Ds. The one that I loved the most was the ZX4000, the Carbon Onyx version. I love that sneaker because the cushioning, for some reason, was actually better. The 4D midsole was kind of softer. The upper looked sick, and that has been my favorite since then. However, today, I have with me a 4D sneaker that I am absolutely loving. Guys, this is the Adidas Consortium. I think it's called the Evo Runner V2. Let's check it out. If you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, please make sure that you do so. We are about to draw the winner to the sneaker of your choice and your size that we can buy from Commonwealth. So make sure that you hit that subscribe button, follow me on Instagram, join our Facebook community, and then click the link in the description box for the rest of the mechanics. Good luck. I bought this sneaker when I was in Las Vegas for the Consumer Electronics Show. I actually covered that event. So if you haven't seen my Las Vegas vlogs yet, I will link it in the description box as well as pinned in the comment section. Binge watch the entire thing. It's a fun playlist. Anyway, so let's get to the shoe. So this is the second generation of the Consortium Runner. I think it was 2018 when the first version came out. And this one has a different color for the upper. And in my opinion, I don't know if it's just my head, but it feels like that the 4D is better. But we'll get to that in a bit. So let's go over the aesthetics of the shoe. If you take a look at the upper, it has multiple layers of materials and textures. You have some sort of like prime knit material over here, which gives breathability and flexibility to your toes. You have suede paneling and nubuck paneling across the side of the sneaker. You have embroidered 3 stripes along the left and the right side of the shoe. And you have some sort, I'm not sure what this is like, some, I don't know, hard leather or plastic that they used for the tongue. For the branding, you have the Adidas logo here, which kind of extends just over the collar of the shoe. You have the Sneaker Consortium handshake logo at the tongue tab. On the left pair, you actually have the Adidas logo. So the Consortium on the right pair tongue, the Adidas logo on the left pair tongue. Now, if you move down, of course, you have the 4D printed midsole, which was created using light synthesis. It's a pretty intricate process. I will put the link down below where I talked about that more in detail when we did the unboxing of the Daniel Ashram 4D together with DJ Big Boy Cheng. Now, I'll talk about the comfort in a bit, so bear with me for a while. Now, if you move inside the sneaker, this is where it becomes like kind of interesting. I mean, it's not game-changing, but it's fun. So they put like the steps on how they actually made the sneaker outlined along the edges of the insole. So it says over here, step 1, data collection, step 2, creating stiffness targets, etc., etc. But what's really cool about this one is that they put some sort of like translucent, transparent material in the middle, so you can actually see through the 4D material from the top, which is something that I've never seen before, because you can see the 4D from the sides. So this particular aesthetic is nice for fans of the 4D technology of Adidas. Now, how is it on feet? Style-wise, I love it. It's easy to wear. It gives a futuristic vibe, which is exactly, I think, what you're running after if you want to wear a pair of 4Ds. Comfort-wise, I feel that the 4D technology here has been fine-tuned. Again, I'm not sure if it's just my head or if it's some sort of like, hey, I kind of accept it now. But it really feels much better compared to the previous ones. Now, the Boost is still far more comfortable than this one, because the Boost gives you a pillowy cushioning effect when it comes to your feet. I mean, your entire feet. And you have an all-around prime knit to be able to wrap your feet around clouds sort of thing. This one is kind of like a softer version of EVA foam. So if the EVA foam is your typical midsole. You find it in most sneakers today. This one is kind of like a softer and better version of that, but it is not dramatically or drastically a big improvement as opposed to, for example, the Boost technology of Adidas or even the React technology of Nike. It's just a few notches better in my opinion. However, what this has going for it that I never really realized before was really the support. And this is something that I realized when I was in Vegas. Because when I was at the Consumer Electronics Show, I was clocking in thousands and thousands and thousands of steps every day. Minimum of 15,000. I went as high as 27,000 in one day. And the day that I hit 26,000 steps, I think I was wearing this shoe. And one of the things that I loved about it was that there was minimal foot fatigue. And that speaks volumes to the support and the stability that actually the 4D and the overall structure of the sneaker delivers. So that one, maybe I might need to correct my earlier review of the 4D because that wasn't something that I was looking for. But after wearing it for like over 20 plus thousand steps, I can pretty much say that at least in stability and support, this one kind of delivers. So is it worth picking up 4D sneakers? It really depends on what you are looking for and what it is that you want in sneakers. I think it is a very subjective choice when it comes to sneakers like this. Subjective and objective. Objective because they're pricey. I mean, not everybody has $350 or 20,000 pesos here in the Philippines to pick a pair of 4Ds up. It's super expensive. You can buy, what, 3 Ultra Boosts from the outlet with 20,000 pesos? So that kind of makes it insane. But hey, if you are a fan of the 4D tech or if you are tired of just Boost and you want to try something else, this might be worth considering. Just manage your expectations because it really won't be as comfortable as to what you're used to. And that's it for a review of the Adidas Sneaker Consortium Evo Runner 4D V2. What do you guys think of the sneaker? Let me know down below in the comment section. I would love to hear from you. Let's get a great discussion going on in the comments box. That said, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I still have a couple more of vlogs coming to you this weekend. I think I'm going to do like 2 a day because there's just so much content that I have planned for you guys. So I hope you do watch them all. And again, please don't forget to watch the Las Vegas playlist. I did sneaker shopping guides, we checked out Urban Necessities, we checked out UNDEFEATED, we went to LA and actually dropped by Riff LA where I was able to pick up the Off-White Dunks over there at the back. Amazing sneaker, by the way. I was blown away with that one. I wasn't expecting it to be as good as it was when I put it on. But anyway, that's it. Peace, God bless, what's up, happy weekend, boom.